Hi, I'm Roger with Lion Technology, and this is the video series where we answer important questions about how to comply with federal and state hazardous waste management regulations that apply to your business. In a recent video, we defined a key term for anyone who deals with hazardous waste, the term generator. In this video, we're going to build on the definition of generator and talk about three size categories that US EPA divides generators into under RCRA. Knowing which of these three categories your facility belongs to is a crucial early step towards proper hazardous waste management. Your generator category determines some very important details like how much hazardous waste your site can generate each month, how long you can store that waste on site, and how you manage it while it's there. Your generator category also determines things like your contingency planning responsibilities and your duties for reporting to EPA or your state. And it dictates when, how, and how often you're required to train your hazardous waste personnel. Before we cover the criteria for all three generator categories, we need to consider a fundamental fact about the United States of America, and that's this. The U.S. is made up of 50 individual states, plus Washington, D.C., Puerto Rico, and other places around the globe. The law that underpins US EPA's hazardous waste regulations, primarily the Resource Conservation and Recovery Act, authorizes each state to develop and oversee its own hazardous waste program. The only catch is that the state's rules must be at least as stringent as the federal regulations. In other words, a state cannot require hazardous waste generators to do less than US EPA does, but they can require you to do more than EPA requires. Most states use the same three size categories for generators as EPA does, but not all of them do. As a generator, it's crucial to know about any extra, stricter, or different rules your state imposes. If you're a Lion member, you can do that by checking out the state summary for your state in the member area now. There are more details and more resources about that in the video description and the comments. Now, let's get to our three categories. We're going to use two terms here, and both of them have specific definitions under RCRA: hazardous waste and acute hazardous waste. If you're unsure about what either one of those means, my recommendation is to take advantage of the resources linked below to find out more, or visit lion.com/RCRA now. Your generator category is calculated based on the amount and type of waste your site generates in any calendar month. Our three categories are large quantity generator, or LQG, small quantity generator, or SQG, and very small quantity generator, or VSQG. You are a large quantity generator if, in any calendar month, you generate 1,000 kilograms or more of hazardous waste, or you generate more than 1 kilogram of acute hazardous waste. You are a small quantity generator if, in any calendar month, you generate more than 100 kilograms but less than 1,000 kilograms of hazardous waste, and you generate 1 kilogram or less of acute hazardous waste. Finally, you are a very small quantity generator if, in any calendar month, you generate 100 kilograms or less of hazardous waste, and you generate 1 kilogram or less of acute hazardous waste. Lastly, if you experience a spill or other cleanup of acute hazardous waste, there is one more thing to consider. If the residue from the cleanup of acute hazardous waste exceeds 100 kilograms in any calendar month, you are a large quantity generator. Thank you for taking some time to watch this video. I hope that this helps you to determine which generator category your facility or facilities belong to. Knowing which generator category your site belongs to is crucial to identify which RCRA regulations apply to you. If you have questions about determining your site's generator status or training your employees on the RCRA hazardous waste regulations, don't hesitate to contact us at Lion Technology. If these RCRA FAQ videos have been helpful to you, please hit that like button. Make sure you subscribe to our channel so you don't miss the next RCRA FAQ video. Thank you again, and I'll see you next time.